I will talk about coordinate systems and frames of reference in this mini screencast. So let's say you have a robot that drives around your carpet. It's a simple differential wheel robot which drives into a certain direction and has a certain position in your environment. So how do you do that? You put a coordinate system into your environment which has an x-axis, a y-axis, and a z-axis, and the position is now given by the translation from the coordinate origin to the robot center. So I have a vector like this, which has an x coordinate, a y coordinate, and a z coordinate. And so in this example, the z coordinate is obviously 0. Now if you put a quadrotor into that same environment, you might have a vector pointing upwards from your origin, which has a z coordinate that is larger than 0. Now, is this all you need to know about the robot? Well, this robot has an orientation which is given by its rotation around the z axis. So this robot could also face this way or could face that way. And every time I project the z axis over here, you can see that there's a rotation around the z axis. Now, for the quadrotor, it's a little more complicated because it can rotate around the x, the y, and the z axis, which are also known as pitch, yaw, and roll. Now, I can draw those orientations on the coordinate system, and I show you which direction is the positive angular rotation. Now, the question is, how did I do that? I used the right-hand rule, which is in the book, and shows your right hand. So you can take your right hand, stretch it out, and then align the x-axis with your thumb, the y-axis with your index, and the z-axis with your middle finger. Now if you draw that, you might rotate your hand around, but if you obey that rule, you can make sure you're consistent in all the corner systems you ever draw and that you ever use. There's a second right-hand rule, which is using the thumb to point into the direction of your axis, and now the direction of your fingers wrapping around the axis give you the direction of the rotation. So now you can verify and see that I'm actually consistent. The right-hand rule applies to the x, to the y, and the z rule, and again I have the same coordinate system as I drew here.